Good morning. Welcome to this final service of the year 2021, this virtual service. God has been with us during the past year. He has been faithful, and we didn't realize at the beginning of the year what we would face. That's sometimes a good thing, but the one constant has been His presence with us, His goodness, and our need for one another. And so it is good when we gather in the house of the Lord to worship. And on this last Sunday, we'll be hearing about praise. We'll be listening to a couple of selections of nice music. And we'll just conclude this year in His presence. Let's pray. Father, we prayed, come, come Emmanuel, come into our world. We wait upon You, we need You, we look to You. And so we thank You that Your grace has sustained us in these past months, that Your mercy is constant, and it's our desire to live justly for You and with those we meet and those who come across our path. Thank You for the North Toronto Community Church, the congregation. We think of the many members, all in different capacities, different ages, different experiences, yet we are all part of Your body, all connected, and so we thank You that You're with us in these days. So on this Boxing Day, we just open our hearts and minds to receive from You Your peace, Your presence, Your promise. And we pray this all in Jesus' name and for His sake. Amen. Amen.
Good morning, friends. I'm happy to be sharing the scripture reading with you this morning, which is found in Psalm 150. And it's a psalm of praise. Praise the Lord. Praise God in His sanctuary. Praise Him in His mighty heavens. Praise Him for His acts of power. Praise Him for His surpassing greatness. Praise Him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise Him with the harp and the lyre. Praise Him with tambourine and dancing. Praise Him with the strings and flute. Praise Him with the clash of cymbals. Praise Him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. May God help us to be a people of praise together. Amen.
It's the day after Christmas, Boxing Day, on a Sunday, a day usually for people to exchange their gifts for different sizes or colors or styles or even something completely different. A day usually for great sales and terrific bargains. Well, if you're anything like me, besides not wanting to do any of this on a Sunday, you try to avoid the big crowds and the jam-packed stores. You simply appreciate any gift given to you. And if there does need to be an exchange, you wait until things have settled down a bit. We all need a little peace and quiet. And so today we have our final psalm for this year. But as we read it or hear it read, it is anything but peaceful and certainly not to be read or heard in quiet. For it's really a great symphony of praise. Praise for who God is and what he means to each one of us. Praise for all the good things that have happened to us this past year, despite COVID and all the restrictions that we have had. We do have much for which to be thankful, for which to give praise. And this is what we're focusing on for these next few moments. Well, what does praise mean to you? After all, the word is used 13 times in just 6 verses. Psalm 150 is the final psalm in the Psalter. And so, to finish, the people compiling the psalms together wanted to give an exultant call to all of us to praise God, to praise our Lord, to give him a hallelujah, a word that has become universal in giving glory and praise and adoration. So often we chronicle our complaints to God. This is going wrong. That has happened to me. Please fix this. Please alter that. And because of all our wants and desires for God to change this and that, we sometimes neglect giving praise to him for all he has done and is still doing for each one of us. The psalmist says we are to praise God in his sanctuary. Corporate worship, corporate praise. Whether we're physically gathered together in church or even in this way, worshiping as a congregation virtually, we are to give praise to God together as the body of Christ. And when we do this, what spiritual exhilaration fills, floods, and oversouls the soul. Communion, together, lifting our hearts to God in praise, there is nothing like it. Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. O my soul, our souls, give praise to the Lord. But then the psalmist says we're also to praise him in the mighty heavens. After all, the whole world is his temple. The sunrise and sunset, the moon, the stars, the animals, the birds, the fish in the sea, the mountains, the oceans, everything created by God is for us to enjoy. And so we give praise to the Almighty. Francis of Assisi, who lived in the 13th century, was often referred to as God's troubadour. His life was marked by a carefree abandonment toward God. He would travel through towns and villages in the Middle Ages, joyfully telling those who would listen all about God, even preaching to the birds and the animals. And now we sing a song with such joy in our hearts, praising God, our Creator. All creatures of our God and King, lift up your voice and with us sing, Alleluia, Alleluia. Thou burning sun with golden beam, thou silver moon with softer gleam. Oh, praise him, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Giving praise is vital for our Christian life. So the psalmist goes on to point out different instruments used for giving praise. After all, it takes a variety of instruments to make a good symphony. The harmony just wouldn't happen if it were just drums or just trumpets. Verses 3-5 calls for a blending of the instruments in order to make sweet music. The strings, the brass, the woodwinds, and yes, even the drums and cymbals. What does all this mean for us? God invites us all in our individual ways to praise him, contributing to this great symphony of praise. Yes, even with a timbrel and some dancing. Are we up for it? Especially the dancing. What does the final verse say? Let everything, everyone, that has breath, praise the Lord. We can think of ourselves as one of the instruments in that great symphony of praise. We're all different. We all express our praise in different ways. Some instruments might even be louder than others, but we are all to blend together and to be tuneful as we give praise to the Almighty, to forever watch and listen to our great conductor as he leads us on. And back to St. Francis's great song, let all things their Creator bless and worship him in humbleness. Oh, praise him, alleluia. Praise, praise the Father, praise the Son, and praise the Spirit, three in one. Oh, praise him, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. C.S. Lewis wrote, all enjoyment spontaneously overflows into praise. The world rings with praise, lovers praising one another, readers praising their favorite poet, walkers praising the countryside, players praising their favorite game. The delight is incomplete until it is expressed in praise. In heaven, one day, our worship and joy and praise will be complete. But until then, we must just tune our instruments as best we can as we take part in the great symphony of praise. It was the composer Haydn who said, when I think of God, my heart is so full of joy that the notes leap and dance as they leave my pen. Beautiful. That's what praising God is all about. And so we say, eternal God, may the Holy Spirit be the conductor of my life, so my whole being will be a symphony of praise to you. Praise my soul, the King of Heaven. And praise begins at home. Yes, in God's house, as we worship him together in a physical sense or in this virtual way because of COVID. Yes, there's nothing quite like corporate worship, but also we're to praise God in our own individual homes. Whether we be a household of six or one, we are to give praise to God in the sanctuary of our own living spaces, to come before God in prayer, giving him all praise and glory and adoration. Do we do this? Do we need to do this even more and more? A symphony doesn't just happen. It requires individual practice and discipline and good intention. After all, don't we want it to be a beautiful symphony? Doesn't our God deserve the very best we can give to him? Let everything that has breath, the psalm says. And who gave us breath in the first place? Therefore, let our breath, our words, our expressions be full of praise to Almighty God. Praise him, Jesus, our blessed Redeemer. And so on this last Sunday of the month and the last Sunday of the year 2021, on this Boxing Day, let us be filled with praise to our Lord and Savior. Let us acknowledge him as our King, Lord, and loving Father. Let us give thanks to him as we, his instruments, join together to make a beautiful symphony of praise. God needs us all, flutes, clarinets, violins, cellos, trumpets, even tubas, drums, and cymbals. We're all so different, yet all so very important and so needed in order to make a beautiful symphony of praise. God loves us all unconditionally and equally. Oh yes, let everything and everyone that has breath praise the Lord as we anticipate a brand new year and great new opportunities before us. Praise the Lord. Amen. And now, let us come before him and simply adore him. I'd invite you to listen to this beautiful song, Gesù Bambino, and as you do, offer your praise to your Lord this day. Thank you.
And now a benediction for our service, for our year, as we thank God for his presence with us and as we look to the future. To him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you before his glorious presence without fault and with great joy, to the only God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, power, and authority through Jesus Christ our Lord, before all ages, now and forevermore. Amen. Amen.